Hello, everyone. This is Fi. I'm checking out Sorceress Testing. This is a new build of a game that I've playtested previously. It was previously known as Project Sorceress, and this is apparently sort of a test area for the game, so it's not going to include the same content from before, which was a sort of level, actually quite a sprawl of level design in the last one I tested, so this is going to be a little different, it seems, but we're going to give this a play test and see if we can give some useful feedback. I did look over the game page here. I'm not going to read it all to you, but it mentioned some known issues, and apparently the developers specifically looking for feedback on moving around, sprinting, dashing, kicking, jumping, crouching. Does it feel good and responsive? So this sort of game feel type stuff. He also asked for feedback on the gamepad support. I'm not sure if I'm going to try that out or not. It's been so long since I've done any first-person games with a gamepad. I think it would just be really awkward for me. So I don't know. But if nothing else, I will give this a try. So I've not seen anything past what you're seeing here. The frame rate doesn't look great so far. I'm noticing it's also... Alright. Let's check the options here. Screen mode, borderless, full screen, that's what we want. VSync off, FPS cap 60, no, we want 120, please. Anti-aliasing. And just make sure that this is in. Looks like it is. Alright, still doesn't look good, is there? Frame rate? Alright, frame rate is at the top of the right. The debug stuff on the right. Yeah, it doesn't... Okay, it feels like there's some smoothing on the mouse movement, which seems really bonkers. I mean, pretty much for, you know, first-person games, you want the camera movement to be pretty much one-to-one with the mouse, you know, kind of the raw input of the mouse, and it feels like if I move it quickly and stop, you can see it kind of slides gradually to a stop. That's probably really bad. I'm just gonna say it. I mean, I don't know why there would be any smoothing on that. I would definitely have a look at that and take that off. You were using keyboard plus mouse. This is a portal to the AI testing zone. There is no way back. Okay. But yeah, I would take off whatever the heck the smoothing is on there. It doesn't feel like the frame rate is super high. I know it looks like it's fine. If I look at the top right there, it's like over 60. You know, clearly it's up in the 80s to 120. But I don't know why. It just feels like it's lower. Movement boots, normal boots, sprint and dash. Icy boot, skate, and trail. Okay. I think it said the controls are in the game. Right input cast, left hand action, left input cast, right hand action. Oh, excuse me. Swap left right input. Now, why would that... I don't know why that would be different by default. That's kind of strange. In my opinion, I guess the thinking is that you're going to put the primary weapon in the right hand and then use the left mouse button for that, and I don't know. Oh, camera smoothing. 50. Can we turn that off then, maybe? I don't know what... Is this supposed to be sensitivity? Is this camera sensibility? Head bob... 10, a field of view is at 100, that sounds okay. Toggle crouch, no thank you. I don't know what this is. It's for gamepad, rebind controls. I guess we have to go in here to... Oh, it's not implemented. Okay, well, supposedly you could see the controls in the game. Let's check this real quick. Alright, we have voices. Graphics, controls, sound. Lots of graphics settings, it's nice. Happy to see all this. Especially with like the full screen modes and the VSync, even the FPS cap. It's nice to have all this stuff. Ah, much better. Okay, so we turn off the smoothing. It's very strange to have that by default. Let's see, it's going down to 70 at least. I don't know if there's... My sensitivity is a little high for me, so let's go ahead and tweak that. Oop. Oh, the smoothing is back. Wonderful. Okay. Oh, it's in controls. So I'm not sure what happened there. Okay, I think I fixed it. I think there's probably a bug in the menu there. Oh, there's a guy over there. It still feels a bit wrong, actually. When I make really small movements, it doesn't feel like I'm used to. I'm not sure... I'm not sure what's going on there. If it has something to do with the smoothing that's there, even if it's set to zero, it doesn't feel quite right. It's quite strange. Alright, E key to pick stuff up. You can. It limits your. Alright, so I think I remember this from before. Like you can still spin around. Wow. Apparently I drop it if I spin too fast. I guess because it's physics enabled. Interesting. Okay, so you can't technically spin as fast as you want because it will drop it. Oops, I'm on fire, I think. No, I set this on fire now. I'm surprised that doesn't seem to... Or did it? Maybe it did douse it. Oh! That was quite a punch. Alright, that felt cool. It takes a long time for this to reset, though. Oh, does it have... Oh, it's got a... Okay, so the meter in the bottom right being used up. Alright. But yeah, I was gonna mention, you know, I'm not sure about the whole, like, limiting the mouse speed when you pick something up. Like, it kind of makes sense, but at the same time, like, you can just move the mouse faster, and that's... Like, if you really want to frantically turn around, you just have to kind of spaz. And it'll still spin around fast, it just... You have to put a lot more effort into it, I don't know. Maybe it's better than alternatives, but... I mean, the other thing you can do is actually... It's more complicated, but you can actually cap the move speed. So instead of the mouse sensitivity, it's actually the camera move speed that you're restricting, so that you, like, you can't move it faster. Even if you, like, go like that, it won't work because it won't turn that fast, you know. So that's something you could consider. Is there a... Oh, we can dash left and right a little bit. We got a meter in the bottom, sort of a stamina type dealy. So it's interesting, we have like... Okay, the bottom left looks like health. The bottom right we have... I guess that's our weapons. And those both have uses meters, and then we have like a completely separate meter for this dashing thing. Okay, we can run too. So apparently that's stamina. So we have stamina also. There's a lot of meters we're talking about. I don't know what to think about the stamina thing. I mean, my general first impression of stamina is that I don't care for it very much. This moves a little slow. I mean, especially if you're going to be using this kind of thing often, it's a bit slow, I would say. Okay, so there's the question of... I'm going back up. Why? Is this a bug? Right, so you can only run forward, you can't run sideways, but if you press to the right, for instance, and then press shift, it'll do this little dash. It doesn't move very far, but it's something. But if you're already holding shift and you press right or left, it doesn't do the dash, so it's kind of... I could see it happening that someone gets this kind of mixed up where they're trying to dash left or right, but you know, you have to kind of program your brain to like let off the shift and then press the direction and then press shift. It's a little unnecessary, maybe. This guy is apparently doing nothing but this. Supposedly there is... Oh, I've got other things, so... I don't know what the heck that is. I can't see it. Oh. Why was there an explosion when I punched? What is exploding? I thought this just did a normal punch. Okay, so mouse wheel down switches your left hand, mouse wheel up switches the right hand, so that's interesting. Seems really awkward. I would definitely change that. If I could rebind it. I like the way the water streams look, even though they kind of curve in a way that doesn't seem natural. It's still pretty cool. So why? For whatever reason, this thing that I'm holding in my right hand makes the punch explode. Like, really insanely. Holy crap! I don't know if that's... I don't think that would be intended. That is quite a launch. I don't know what the deal is with that. He really launches you. Alright, so... You have to be pretty darn close for him to hit you. He's got a shield. I don't know if this even works. Doesn't seem to work on him, okay. What is in the middle now? We've got red. Okay, that's the, okay, that's the bottom right is being shown in the cursor in the middle, so that's kind of nice. Bottom right meters. Now supposedly you can kick. So you can kick out of holding something, that's nice. Launch these particularly far, but maybe that's kind of realistic. Okay, this is exploding again. I don't know. It's only when you actually hit something with it. I think it's supposed to, okay, I think the explosion is only supposed to happen when you actually hit something with the fist. For some reason, when I have this item out, it causes it to happen. So it seems like a bug. I don't know what this is because it doesn't seem to work. Maybe that was mentioned on the game page. Normal boots, sprint and dash, which I think is what I have already. Did that? Oh, I think it did change, okay. Okay, but why? For what purpose? Like, eventually you can pick up a lot of speed. Oh, you take fall damage. I took a lot. Oh, it's one of these things. Okay, I like this kind of thing where, like, you take... Oh, I was afraid I was gonna die. You take a lot of damage, like a big chunk of it will recharge if you allow it to. Like, not taking more damage or something. I tend to like that kind of thing in games. But yeah, so this sliding boots... You can pick up a lot of speed, but you have to go in one direction for, like, quite a while. And then it's, like, really hard to adjust. My opinion doesn't feel that good. I mean, the only thing I can really think of using this for would be if there was... I mean, this just happens to kind of conveniently have some fun ramps here. If there's something that you just needed to go particularly fast to to launch yourself over something like this. I don't know, this is gonna kill me. Wait, what happened to my health? I remember getting hurt that one time, but I don't remember getting hurt again, so I'm not sure what happened. In any case, yeah, I mean, this doesn't feel very good to me, and the trail thing doesn't seem useful. Like, if it's meant to be other than visual, I don't see what that would accomplish. Oh gosh, you can launch yourself with a fist. That seems a little excessive. I could see, like, you know, trying to fight a bad guy and, like, launching yourself off a cliff or something. And, like, taking fall damage and dying or, you know, who knows what. Definitely seems a little excessive. Like, if I'm standing on the ground and it just kind of bumps me back like that, that's one thing. But if it's kind of... apparently you can use it as a jump. Like, instead of a rocket jump, you have a fist explosion jump. Which is actually pretty fun to jump like this, but... yeah, it seems really dangerous, so... might be worth eyeballing that carefully. We got the doors, which I believe swing both ways, which is pretty cool. Depending on where you open it. Actually like that quite a bit. These... alright, they seem stuck together for a moment there, but... yeah, again with the stamina, I don't... It recharges pretty fast, so that's good. Oh, I forgot about the... okay, so you can't side dash with these. All you can do is... slowly pick up speed. Which again... 10 degrees. I guess this is testing different inclines for whatever reason. Oh, you kind of... I guess there's some kind of little fling that happens when you skate up a ramp and then... oh, okay. You hit the top of it. Are we back? Okay, still have the ice boots. I want to get the other... yeah, I'm not sure about the dash. You know, at the least you can make it so that if you're holding shift and you press that way. I mean, not if... like, okay, so if you're holding W and you press shift, you do the run, right? And then if you press A or D, you should do like a diagonal. But if you're only pressing A or D and you're holding shift, I think you should do the dash. So that you don't have to worry about which one you press first. I mean, sometimes if you try and do it real fast, you might, you know, your finger might just accidentally, inadvertently, press down the A or D key before you hit the shift key, you know. If you're trying to play really fast, that kind of thing can happen a lot, and it's like, you know, why isn't it working? So I would consider that change. The other thing is the dash is, it's pretty slight. I mean, maybe it's enough, it just doesn't feel like much. Oh gosh, that guy seems to launch you like as soon as his animation starts, I think. I think the hitbox is like constantly active or something. Yeah, you can see like when he's bringing it back, it still knocks me. I don't think that should be active unless he's actually doing the swing. Oh, I launched onto the ladder. The ladder, I'm still not sure about how it depends on the way you're looking. Okay. I would consider making that just go up or down if you're pressing W or S and not depend on the way you're looking. Okay, how do you bubble? E? Hold E? I never actually did see what the controls were, because... oh, wait, maybe this? Oh, okay. Alright, PC controls. Drag, kick, spacebar, jump. Controls, crouch. Excuse me, shift and others. Sidestep, mouse wheel up. mouse wheel down. See, I would change the mouse wheel controls for this. You know, I'd naturally expect that to be rebindable in the final version anyways, but this feels really awkward. Like having to use mouse wheel up for one weapon and mouse wheel down for the other. It's pretty strange in my opinion, and I guess... Oh, held attack. Oh, okay, you just tap it. Okay. And I'm in a bubble right now. Which is a little hard to tell, it just kind of makes the screen slightly blue tint. Probably improve the visual feedback on this. Also, like, what can you do with this? Does it have an actual use? Apart from being kind of cute and potentially really annoying, actually, if you're like in combat or something. Before you could like float way up into the air, but now you just kind of bounce. It almost feels like it's detrimental, if anything. So the fist, I think it'd be cool if you could charge it, kind of, like click and hold, and then, you know, you just kind of pull it back a bit and then let go. And it's pretty cool, it just kind of blows up whatever's in front of you. But, I wonder if you can... Okay. Did that throw? That kind of is a throw. Okay. Kick. I don't know what this is supposed to be. I don't know if I should mess around with that cart. Just kind of going in circles. I don't know if there's much purpose to that. I think maybe we want to go in here. I don't know if there's any other weapons. Yeah, I think we just have these two weapons right now. The other one is, I think this one is kind of bugged out and doesn't do anything. That was cute sounding. This lever does nothing. This lever gets you back, resets the level. Wait a minute. What just happened? That's not nothing. It spews what? Food? I think it's for your health. Alright, something's... I think this is hitting the lever. So we got some wonky physics interactions. Let's go ahead and... We want to push it, right? It's not going to pull. Oh, okay, so the settings, some of the settings here reset. Oh, what was the set? Oh, crap. I think when I hit the reset the level lever, that reset this, I don't remember what I set this to. No, we want this. Save and back. Hopefully, no, that didn't work. Reason. Alright, that's better. I don't know if the sensitivity is where I wanted it, and it feels more sensitive than it needs to be, but that's okay, we'll just roll with it for now. They punch you and you get launched. You don't seem to aggro, you don't seem interested in attacking me. He's getting back up. Oh, I can use the shield. Okay. Left mouse button to push. Hold it to block. It takes a while for it to go into the blocking state, which... Oh. That didn't seem to help. I don't think this works. push work? I think the game page mentioned that the shield wasn't working very good, but this doesn't seem to do much of anything right now. I think you can kind of see some kind of, okay, animation. Maybe not, maybe he's just doing the flailing thing. Alright, yeah, it's not good to get like this close to the enemy where it's like constantly like moving around you really weirdly. It's hard to track him and he can't even seem to hit me. I don't know. I guess I just ran out of health and it stopped hurting. I think that's what happened. There's no like death going on here. Hold mouse wheel down to drop. Okay. I like that you can pick up the dropped shields though. That's really cool. Alright, that just pushes them. And I can only assume the enemies aren't dying either. For whatever reason. But yeah, it definitely feels like if I hold down the mouse button for the fist, it just does nothing. It just feels really wrong. Like even when I let go, it doesn't just fire normally, it just does nothing. It only works if I tap it, so it definitely feels like it should be able to charge that or at least hold it. You know, even if it doesn't like affect the damage or anything, like just being able to hold it and then let go could feel nice. Hello? That was weird. Did I not have any stamina or something? I ran out of something or other. This looks like it could be useful, but I don't think I can actually interact with this object. What happened to that guy? I think. Whoa! Oh, okay, hitting the G key changes between something like this, I think. Hopefully this is still hooked in. Right. I hit the G key accidentally. It's right next to the F for the kick, so. Right, so they can die. I'm hoping you can kick doors to like knock enemies on the other side of them or something. I don't think there's anywhere else I can go, is there? Let's see. I forgot I can sprint. That's one of the things is, alright, we can get out of here, but that's annoying to me about the idea of stamina. Wow, this always jumps forward. Oh, okay, this is the way to do it. But that's one of the things that's annoying to me about the idea of you using stamina is that I feel like I can't just like press shift whenever I want to for just normal moving around because I have a depletable resource that I'm supposed to be mindful of, so I just don't use it that much. It's just kind of annoying to have that extra thing to have to think about and worry about, in my opinion, so. What is going on? Did I accidentally spawn all these with that lever? I think that's what happened. Oh, that bounces higher, I think, when you shoot it from up higher. I wonder if I could. Oh, it didn't work at all. Okay. Oh no! My way back up! Oh, it didn't bounce higher at all. Well, that's disappointing. I hope that it would, like, bounce me up real high because I jumped from up there. It's pretty disappointing. This works. Alright, so I guess the only tools I have to actually do damage is my explodey fist. Oh, he flashes for a long time. Why is he still flashing? I don't think that's normal. Stop flashing. I'm also kind of surprised these boxes don't just explode. That one did, but... What are these? Oh, just parts of the box. Oh no, that's annoying. So that's exactly what I was talking about before, too. Why am I turning orange? The UI was glowing there for a moment. These guys are just hanging out. Sounds like it's raining. I think it's just the physics interactions here. Actually, it might be... Alright, so I think this door is like on fire or something. It doesn't really look like fire, it just looks like it's glowing. I mean, it kind of looks like a cinder. Like glowing cinders, but it doesn't give the appearance of something on fire. But I think... Oh, this actually works too. I think that's what I'm hearing, is like a bunch of... I think it's from the explodey fist. I think it sets things on fire. And then I get a lot of these flame loops. Audio flame loops stacking here. Why is it? Oh, there's just a cute sound when you jump, okay. Jumping feels nice. I don't like the stamina. I'm like having to like wait. Just have to like stop and wait for my stamina to recharge. I don't want to play an action game like that really, because it's like, I mean, obviously there are games that make it work, but it just seems really unnecessary. I don't think it actually does any damage. It goes so slow. Whoa, it started moving around really fast though. That was kind of weird. See, unfortunately, I mean, there's not really much in the way of combat right now, so... I think if you kind of... You know, obviously the game is in an unfinished state, but... you kind of work on... getting the combat a little more functional, then you can like actually kind of play it more, you know, as an actual game, in a sense, so you can kind of test out the way things feel in that regard. Right now all I can do is punch guys. Everything else is just kind of useless. The shield didn't really work quite, it didn't seem to work quite the way I expected, although the idea behind it seemed good, so that's cool, but... Yeah, it just seems like there's just a few missing pieces in terms of, like, even just being able to fight these guys. That if they were in place, I feel like I could, you know, kind of test and give more feedback in the sense of how combat's working. But, yeah, I wish I could do more with this bounce. I don't see any actual purpose to it right now. I can't, like, bounce up high or anything. I guess in theory you could use it as a sort of long jump, but it seems like it'd be a little hard to orchestrate and it's not giving you that much. Oh gosh, everything's setting everything else on fire. I don't know. It's really weird, but... Yeah, the visual effects of the fire just seems very bizarre. I think it would be nice to have something that, you know, actually looked like flames going on here, but at least they're actually getting destroyed. I'll save you. You were water anyways. I don't know what the purpose of... Oh, I hit the G key again. Crap. Oh my gosh, alright. That's not what I meant at all. Did I mess up? Okay. I think I reset the sensitivity, probably. Feels really sensitive. I wonder if this scales based on what you set the sensitivity to, or if this is always the same. The smoothing's back on. Alright, I think this is... still feels too sensitive, I don't know. Okay, this guy does some flips. See, I'm not sure what else to test. I mean, I can't really even use this side dash thing. I mean, I still feel like it's a little too... like it just doesn't move you far enough. Be very useful, but I guess there was that one guy at the previous place that kind of had a did some combat stuff. I could have. Well, I guess I killed all the guys that were doing combat stuff. I don't even remember like where those guys were exactly. Oh, Bully Man. I think it's over here then. Yeah, but they all died, right? Or did one respawn? Oh, wait, what? Guys are fighting each other. You wanna fight me? Hey. Okay, you don't care about me no more. It's kind of weird how he changes targets like that, especially. You know, you kind of expect dudes to kind of prioritize you. Unless they have a reason not to, like, just to kind of change their mind like that is a little weird. So I guess he takes some fall damage or something. Do I not take hits? I'm still at zero, so zero health, so I don't know, I think I should have gotten health somewhere. Oh. Wait, there's a... this is supposed to do something. I don't know. Wait, unlock? Oh, here we go, okay. Spawn torch, spawn, box barrel. For what purpose? What is the other thing? Slow-mo. These are the debug buttons. I think there was another thing. I was trying to get my health back, but I don't think I have that power. Ooh. What the heck? Wait, what? Oh, this does not work normally at all in slow motion mode. Might be nice if you could do the little side dash in the air. Alright, he's super dead. Can get up falls. It's been that way the whole time, I think. Get some water on ya. Oh, he has a million HP. Oh, wrong button. Ooh, well, what else do we do? So weird how much you launch yourself. I do think it's fun doing the jump with it, but like when you're just trying to use it normally and you launch yourself off of something, it's pretty annoying. But that kind of thing is fun. So we got a big window into the abyss. Oh, that didn't take long. I thought I was gonna fall further. I didn't get my health back. Where were those levers from before? think it's over here. Yeah, that sound is from the box hitting one of these levers. Shut up. So the kick doesn't really seem to do any actual damage. I don't know. There's some physics interaction just launched me real fast. So of course there's always a danger in using this much physics of just jank like that. Also interesting to me how I guess it's just inanimate objects that just float straight up while the enemies and the player kind of bounce now. I don't know. Lever gets you back, resets level, does nothing. Alright, so we got our smoothing on the camera back. What is in here? It's just a person over here, right? Oh, no face. I'm gonna try this one more time. See if that works. Yes, okay. So I do believe if I set the smoothing off as the last action, it saves it, but if I don't, it might not. But I don't feel like testing that any further than I have already. Alright, that doesn't help. That actually does work. I like that. The brute force. I quite like that. Oh, so there actually are particles for like flames and stuff. Let's put you out. Okay, he's not aggroed anymore. I don't know what happened. Hello? Alright. It does work. They have... Yeah, it seems like they have just enough of a telegraph, so it's not like ultra easy, but it's enough that you can get out of the way, so that's good. So I mean, the dodge, it does seem to work. I think it's going to be better than just trying to sidestep. There's some inertia on the movement, so it's not super fast. Well, that wasn't even... Okay, sometimes he dashes forward and sometimes he doesn't. Alright, so just normal sidestepping is... not always gonna work. He just stops to get the box out of the way. So if I hold left or right, though, right, it didn't work that time. That time it did. So it might work to avoid his attack. I get really close. Come closer. Like it when it seems like it doesn't work. It's probably because of that. What I talked about before, like you have to press the buttons in the right order kind of thing. Oh, you can dash backwards. Oh, that's nice. You can do backwards diagonal too. That's cool. I think it might be nice if there's just a little more of a bump of speed when you start running. Like, it's not that it feels wrong or anything, but, you know, there is that little bit of inertia, so it starts a little slow and then kind of quickly picks up, but I think it might be nice if you get, like, a really kind of a good kick-off-the-floor kind of deal when you start moving forward with a pretty good speed, because I think it might be cool, especially if you're, like, fighting a guy or something, if you just want to, like, charge him down. If you try and do that with a normal dash, it just kind of seems like it's a little too slow to, to really feel like you want it to. It just takes, like, a half second to... Not even a half second, but 300 milliseconds or something to hit that top speed. I don't think this actually works. Yeah, it takes a long time to go into the actual defensive. Okay, I'm out of health again. I don't know. I don't think this actually works to test anything when I don't have health, unfortunately. Wait, if I break stuff... Oh, there's no food in here. Okay, I think one of these gives food. Down. One of you gives food, I know it does. Give me that. Nom. Oh, I killed the guy. Will he respawn? I don't think he respawns. In any case, I mean, playing with this little dodge more, I think in the context of, like, actually fighting this one character, it seems pretty good. It doesn't seem inadequate or anything. It actually seems to work quite well. Hello. But there's also the question, like, what are other characters going to look like and act like and be like, so we only have this one so far. Okay, so I think when I'm holding the shield and I get hurt, it just doesn't have any feedback or something, because it's like, I always find out that I have no health when I'm trying to use this. And I think it's just because I do get hurt, but I just don't notice it. And alright, I think, I don't know if it was me. Yeah, you can block the lever yourself. That's really annoying. That doesn't seem necessary. I didn't even mean to hit that lever. That's okay. But yeah, I mean, there's always this concern of the over-reliance on physics and all the little problems that can cause. So, you know, that's stuff that you definitely have to be careful of, and I think, yeah, the fact that you can block the levers with your body seems really off. I don't think I can imagine any utility for that. It just kind of feels wrong. I mean, it's kind of normal in a game to kind of run up to a lever and press the button, and if you do it and it just doesn't work, it's like, what the heck? You know what I mean? Really janky. Actually kind of puts like a force on you. Why am I on fire? Oh. I guess these are physics enabled as well. Right mouse button is hit. Hold right mouse button to throw. So presumably you can set people on fire. It's a nice charge up and throw. That feels pretty good. If you could throw, it might be nice to throw like even more objects, even a shield or something. What is this supposed to be? Geometric object. Alright, we are going up the ladder. I did not intend to go up the ladder, but we're going up the ladder. So if I'm over here, it just kind of snaps to the ladder. I think it's like collision based or something. Like, I don't know what the magic solution is for how to handle ladders, but maybe, you know, at least make it so that you have to actually face the ladder somewhat before it. Looks like you can even back into it. Yeah, so. A little awkward. I think I'm running out of things to give feedback on. Oh, the skate zone. Okay, let's try our skatey things again. Oh, this is, I was already here before. Okay, so yeah, so I think it seems like the ramps was kind of the idea behind the skating thing. Where was that? Oh, I still have them. Yeah, I can't say I particularly like it, but the idea of, you know, going off ramps with speed is pretty cool, I guess. But it's just that, like, all the other movement beside that, you know, just holding forward and watching yourself go fast. Like, trying to change direction, it just doesn't work. It's super slow, and it takes a long time to build up and everything, and it's, like, it's pretty annoying, in my opinion. Oh, and if you have, because there's some inertia on the movement, I think, like, if you, like, quickly, Like if I really quickly just press forward and shift, if I was like going to the right and I just press forward and shift, even though I'm only holding forward, I kind of start going to the right. You can see I'm kind of sliding to the right, or I'll do it to the left, right? Like I keep going to the left because I still have the inertia. It doesn't just go straight forward. Even though I'm only holding forward when I press the shift key, just because that's the inertia that I have when I start pressing shift. So that combined with the fact that it's like you have like ultra inertia when you're using these, it's pretty annoying. So you know, I would consider reworking this somehow. I don't know how exactly. What is that? Okay, let's go up this ladder real quick and then I'll probably wrap this up, but I think that the AI is pretty cool. I mean, obviously it could be polished up a bit, but you know, it has some cool interactions and the combat feels like it could be pretty good. I kind of like the way that's feeling, but yeah, it definitely feels like it could be a little better. Other stuff in there, you know, just extra polish. Would be cool if you could put them into stun states and things like that. Wow. Okay, I actually expected to be able to like jump on top of that and like ride it around. Didn't think it was just gonna launch me. What the heck is this? Has that always been there? I just don't even remember this being here. Look at this big thing. This is actually hilarious. I guess it's too big to pick up, but you can kind of start to. Oh, or maybe it's because, oh yeah, you can pick it up. I actually think this is really fun. Like the idea of, can you imagine if it had spikes on it or something and there's like a bunch of guys and you just kicked it at them? Just like rolled across the floor and imagine it weighs like a ton and just runs over everyone. That would be fun. That'd be real fun. All right, normal run. Wait, is it supposed to grab? Okay. This just goes up into the sky. All right. So yeah, I'll probably wrap this up. I think it's really cool. It obviously needs more polish on a lot of little things, but yeah, I'd like to see just some more work with putting the enemies, or just more work into the combat in general. Ooh, what? There's a object here. Strange shader. Oh. Okay, that's cool. But yeah, if you just put together like a pure combat demo or something. Just kind of work on polishing that up. I think that would be a good direction. Because, like I said, I think it has promise, but I think, you know, just stuff needs more polish. You know, obviously the shield didn't work. All those other little things here and there. But hopefully this was a useful video for you. I'm really kind of eager to see kind of where this goes. I do feel like it has a lot of potential, so let me know if you have any questions. And yeah, I look forward to trying out whatever the next build is, so whenever that happens. And I will see you in the next one.